Welcome to the blog VWant, a blog for bloggers. The today topic is to fix CLS issues, the part 1 of Core Web Vitals series. Well, has your web page reported more than a 0.25 CLS score in the Google Page Speed Insights tool? If yes, then continue watching this video. Today we are going to show you the top 6 possible reasons of bad CLS score with their solutions. So without any delay, let's get started. Well, CLS is one of the 3 core web vitals of a Google Page Experience algorithm. Basically, it measures the stability of the web page, or in other words, how many elements of the web page move or shift as the page loads. A web page should maintain or score less than 0.1 CLS to provide a good experience. Well, there could be a lot of reasons for high CLS scores. Some of the major reasons are these. We are going to cover each CLS reason that could be shown in your Google Page Speed Insights tool. Let's start with CLS issue 1, and that is missing image dimensions. Well, are you facing this error of image elements do not have explicit width and height in the Google Page Speed testing tool? This is happening because some of the images or videos used on your website are missing the size attribute. When there is no width and height is defined explicitly, the browser could not able reserve the space for such elements. At the moment such images or videos load, the other elements of the web page like HTML text or CSS shift upwards or downwards, leading to a bad page experience and impacting the CLS score. For this CLS issue, there can be 2 possible fixes. The first fix is to add missing image and video dimensions manually. With the Google Page Speed tool, you can able to figure out the image or video name that does not have the width and height mentioned. After that, open up the post or page in edit mode and tap on the image, and from the right enter the missing height or width. The second fix for this CLS issue is my favorite. Here you can use the WP Rocket plugin, which will add missing height and width attributes automatically as soon as your website page starts loading. You just need to enable the Add Missing Image Dimensions module located under the Media tab and you are good to go. Well, if your site is using fonts hosted from another site, for example Google Fonts, then this might be impacting the CLS score of your site. Whenever someone opens your website, the browser takes time to download that font from the server. During this time, all those elements that using the hosted font will be hidden, and the browser shows a fallback font which is defined in a CSS file. As soon as the hosted fonts are downloaded, the browser will replace the fallback fonts with them, and it may cause CLS shift because of the font size difference. So what are the solution to the hosted web fonts that causing CLS shift? It's simple, by applying the rel equals preload attribute, you can force the browsers to download such fonts as a priority. Even the Google Page Speed tool suggests you to apply preload on all those high priority resources that should be served as soon as possible. So in the first fix of this CLS issue, you can apply preload on hosted fonts manually. Suppose the fonts are hosted from Google Fonts servers, then you will find the link of the Google Fonts stored in the header.php file of your website. You will probably see the Google Fonts script in the header.php file similar to this. Then we just need to add the rel equals preload attribute and link back to the CSS file. After that, it looks like this. I would suggest you take a backup of the header.php file before making any changes to it. Well, those who don't want to involve in a coding mess can take the help of a plugin like WP Rocket. Whether you want to optimize Google hosted fonts or self-domain hosted fonts, WP Rocket plugin got you covered. The WP Rocket preload module helps you to quickly optimize self-hosted fonts. You just need to copy the link of the fonts shown in the Google Page Speed tool and paste it into the fonts to preload section. Similarly, when you just want to optimize the Google hosted fonts, navigate to the Tools tab of the WP Rocket plugin and then enable the Google Font Optimization module. The third possible reason for the bad CLS shift is the elements like buttons, pop-ups, sticky bars, etc. that appear dynamically above the fold content. So what is the solution of such dynamic elements? It's simple, just delay the execution of all those scripts that are injected dynamically above the fold until user interaction. By doing this, the CLS of your web page won't be impacted, because as per the Google Core Web Vitals guidelines, only those layouts shifts are counted which occurs before the user interaction. So in the implementation part, first you have to gather all those problematic scripts from the Google Page Speed tool that are currently appearing above the fold. Check these sections of Google Page Speed for finding such scripts. After that, you can use the WP Rocket plugin and navigate to the Delay JS execution module and enable it. Then insert the URLs of all those scripts which has been injecting dynamically. After that, all those scripts you have put above will be delayed and only execute when there is a user interaction occur on the page. Hence there is no impact on the CLS score. Similar to JavaScript, dynamic ads supplied by the ad networks cause layout shifts badly. In the modern world of advertising, almost all top ad networks using dynamic ads, and due to this we could not define a fixed space for ads. These are some of the common practices to eliminate the effect of this issue on a CLS score. The best alternative solution for this CLS issue is the WP Rocket plugin approach. We saw in the previous CLS issue that WP Rocket is able to delay the execution of dynamic JavaScript, so you'll glad to know that Google Ads script is one of them. WP Rocket automatically delays the execution of the Google Ads script. Apart from this, if your website running ads from other ad networks, then you can manually insert the links of those scripts under the scripts to delay box. The next CLS issue is bad animations. Well, if the animations appeared in a way that shifts the content unexpectedly, then both user experience and CLS score would be impacted. Google doesn't like that. They clearly mentioned in their CLS optimization guide that animations should be moved naturally from one position to the next on the page. So what is the solution to avoid bad animations? The hack is simple. You just need to use the CSS transform property for animating elements. With the transform property, the layout won't be shifted at any cost. Avoid moving or animating elements with changing height and width properties. Let's see the last CLS issue, and that is unreserved embeds dimensions. The problem with embeds that the browser doesn't know what embeds is supposed to contain until they are requesting from the server. It could be a YouTube video, GPS maps, Instagram story, and whatnot. Due to this, a browser can't reserve an exact size for embeds. And this leads to a shift in layout and hence impacted the CLS core web vital of your website. The only solution to deal with this CLS issue is to manually reserve a space for embed that we are going to load on our webpage. For demo purposes, I am going to embed a YouTube video through the WordPress Gutenberg editor. After that, just preview the post. Now we have to determine the final height of this YouTube embed. Now on the preview page, open up the Inspect Element window of the browser. For this, right click on the browser and choose Inspect. This is the source code of your web page. To find the height of the embed block, simply search embed word and try to find the highlighted embed block by hovering on a source code. In our case, the maximum height a YouTube embed will require to load perfectly is 416.25 pixels. And note down the class name of this embed box. In my case it is wp-block-embed_wrapper. Now with the help of CSS, you can reserve the correct height for the embed box. To apply a CSS style to the embed block of our website, we can use the customizer feature of WordPress. In the additional CSS option here, you just need to input this CSS code to reserve the height for the embed box. Just remember, if you want to reserve a space for different embed types, for example Instagram posts, then you have to follow the same procedure. After this procedure, whenever the embeds load on your website, the container or the embed block of your website will be resized automatically according to the dimensions we manually configured. As a result, the layout or the CLS of your website won't be impacted. So this is all about the Core Web Vitals Series Part 1. If you want more information, visit our article, and also don't forget to watch LCP and FID Core Web Vitals videos.